Good afternoon, parents. As we are forced to be physically separate from one another, I want to invite you into my home by video this week. The theme that I have heard this week from parents, teachers, and students is routine. Although all of our community members would like to be like physical school to resume, virtual school has started to become routine. The week is beginning to take on a rhythm of its own, and everyone is becoming accustomed to the part they must play. At the same time, we continue to make iterative adjustments to the structure of virtual school based on feedback from parents, students, and teachers. As an example, you will have noticed the addition of Roar Day this week in elementary school and adjustments to the Thursday schedule in middle school and high school. We hope to make our adjustments fast enough to be responsive, but slow enough not to be disruptive. It is a balance, and we invite you to provide feedback through a survey link again this week to help us get that balance right. Your feedback is helping us to make weekly adjustments to our virtual school structure, but at the same time, we're also doing scenario planning. Of course, one of those scenarios includes the possibility that we have virtual school through the end of the year. As part of that planning, teachers are identifying the highest priority curricular objectives that students must master before next year. These objectives will then inform our virtual school activities. While it's tempting to view virtual school as simply a burden to bear, it's possible to view it from a different vantage point. For a century, the global educational community has been making incremental progress away from rote learning toward learning of skills that will enable students to innovate. While there has been widespread agreement that assessing knowledge that can be easily Googled or queried from Alexa or Siri is not useful, it is still possible to construct assessments in physical classrooms that test such knowledge. In a virtual environment, however, such assessments are not feasible. This crisis drives us toward assessment practices that are rich and authentic. Shifting towards these practices not only serves as a fix for the problem at hand, they will also make our practices fundamentally better for the future, thus allowing us to better meet our mission to inspire innovation and compassionate action. I wish you all a safe and healthy weekend with your families. Take care.